बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम एफसेक्स ऑनलाइन सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम क्लास 10 वीक 11 लेसन 4 सब्जेक्ट इज केमिस्ट्री प्रिपेयर्ड बाय शाजिया नाज। यूनिट विल बी केमिकल इक्विलिब्रियम एंड आवर टॉपिक इन दिस वीडियो इज रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन। सोर्सेज रिक्वायर्ड आर केमिस्ट्री टेक्स्ट बुक। Objective of our video will be we are going to learn about chemical reaction, that what is chemical reaction, forward reactions and reverse reactions, and reversible reaction and dynamic equilibrium. So let us start from a chemical reaction, that what is chemical reaction. You will be frequently using the word chemical reaction has occurred. So what is basically chemical reaction? A chemical reaction is a process in which reactant converts into product. It's not necessary that always two things or more than two combine to form a product. It may be break down to form the product. So a chemical reaction is something that the reactant is converting into product. There are different ways in which a chemical reaction occurs. Let's suppose addition reactions occur, decomposition reactions occur, displacement reactions occur, double displacement reactions occur, neutralization reactions occur. So in a chemical reaction, the main thing is that we have a reactant that is converted into a product by any of the method they follow, maybe addition, decomposition, displacement. In a chemical reaction, reactants and products are separated from one another by drawing arrows. So the main thing in a chemical reaction is that how we can know that which is reactant and which is product. We separate them out by the arrow. The arrow may be single-headed or double. That depends that which type of reaction is occurring. Chemical reaction. Now look at here, we have carbon that is obtained from coal that combines with oxygen, O2, combines to form carbon dioxide. So here the arrows is pointing towards CO2. So CO2 is our product and carbon plus oxygen is our reactant. So reactants are converting into product. Now we have different types of reaction. The main two types we are going to discuss here are irreversible reaction and reversible reaction. That what is irreversible reaction and what are reversible reaction. Some chemical reaction can occur only in one direction. These reactions are called irreversible reaction, or you can also say that irreversible reactions are unidirectional. They occur at once, that the reactant, let's suppose we are having a reactant that will be converted into product, whereas reversible reactions are those which occurs in two directions. What is meant by two directions? That is forward and reverse reaction. In a reversible reaction, the reaction goes from left to right. It will be said that a forward reaction occur, or when it is going from right to left, it is known as reverse reaction. So the reactant can be converted into product and the product can again be converted into the reactant. So such type of a reaction is known as reversible reaction. Look at here, we are having example. Let's suppose we are having fuel, petrol, or take a wood that once burned, the process of combustion occurred. It produced carbon dioxide and H2O. By burning, let's suppose you are having the example of wood, you burn the wood. So by burning wood, ashes are produced. Can you reconvert these ashes into wood again? No. So the combustion reaction is a irreversible reaction example. Secondly, now look at the water molecule. When you combine hydrogen with oxygen, it forms a product H2O. Similarly, let us start heating this water molecule. When we start heating it, after boiling point, the H2O molecule will be break down again into H2 and O2. So this reaction is irreversible reaction. So how can I differentiate Let's suppose I'm not given that whether a reaction is irreversible or reversible. How can I differentiate that the reaction is reversible and irreversible? The representation is the main thing in irreversible and reversible reaction. The irreversible reaction are represented by a single headed arrow, whereas the reversible reactions are represented by double arrow. So by looking at the arrow that is present between the reactants and product, we can recognize at which reaction is it. It is a irreversible reaction or a reverse reaction. Now, what are the characteristics of reversible reaction? For a reversible reaction, the conditions, temperature, pressure, concentration must be kept constant. Similarly, these reactions never goes to completion unless or until the conditions are changed. For example, the reactant will be converted into the product. So when the concentration of the product is high, the product will be again reconverted into the reactant. So these reactions are continuous. At equilibrium, the concentration of the product and reactant remain same. The ratio of the product and the reactant will be constant. Concentration time graph. What is concentration time graph? It is a graphical representation that is used for chemical equilibrium reactions. Rate of the chemical equilibrium. That what is chemical equilibrium? A state of a chemical reaction in which forward and reverse reaction take place at the same rate is called as chemical equilibrium. We are again and again using the word forward and reverse reaction. So what are the forward and reverse reaction? Forward reaction means that the reactants are converting into product. This is forward reaction. And reverse reaction means that the product are reconverting into the reactant. So it is reverse reaction. When the rate of forward reaction become equals to the reverse reaction rate, the state is known as chemical equilibrium. So reversible reaction will always have a chemical equilibrium when the rate of forward reaction becomes equal to the rate of the reverse reaction. We said that the reaction is at an equilibrium stage. Equilibrium means equal. Conversion of the product into the reactant are also known as equilibrium. Okay. Chemical reaction is a dynamic equilibrium. Here a most important question sometime arise that chemical equilibrium can also be called as dynamic equilibrium. Why? Dynamic means in motion. So when we say that the chemical reaction has been reached to equilibrium state, or we can say that the reaction is at equilibrium state, that does not mean the reaction has stopped. The reaction does not stop, but the rate of the forward, or you can say that the ratio of the conversion of the product into the reactant and the reactant into the product becomes equal. So chemical equilibrium is a dynamic equilibrium. This is because reaction does not stop when they come to equilibrium state. The individual molecules keep on reacting continuously, but there is no change in the actual amount of reactants and products. This means concentration of the reactant and product become constant at equilibrium state. Okay, here are some most important questions related to the topic that from this topic. Here are the most important questions that can be: what is chemical equilibrium? Explain with a graph. The next question is, what is the difference between forward and reverse reaction? Whenever the question of the difference comes, you always have to draw a line. In one column you write forward and another you write reverse reaction, and then differentiate it. Always remember that give the equations, okay, examples. The more you give example, the more you attract the checker towards your question. Why chemical equilibrium is also known as a dynamic equilibrium, or you can say that the chemical equilibrium is also known as dynamic equilibrium. Why? You just have to give the reason that why we call it a dynamic equilibrium. And the last and the most important question is, what is the difference between reversible and irreversible reaction? First, you have to draw two columns, and one you have to write reversible reaction and the next is irreversible reaction. Then first write their definitions. The next will be give example. The more you give example, the more you can gain your marks. And the last will be representation. That how can you differentiate the reversible reaction from irreversible reaction by symbols. So for a reversible reaction, you have to draw a double arrowhead. And for the irreversible reaction, you have to draw a single arrowhead. Thank you. Hope you like the video and learn a lot from it.